Welcome to the Tascam Model 12. In this video, we will show the basic instructions on setting up the Model 12 as a control surface for your digital audio workstation. This video is specifically for Ableton Live. If you don't have Ableton Live, see the other videos for your particular DAW. Connect the Model 12 USB cable to your computer. Model 12 uses a USB-C connector. Some modern computers will also have a USB-C connector. This computer we are using today has a USB-A connector, so the cable we need is this common USB-C to USB-A cable. Make sure the cable supports USB 2 or higher. Next, put the input mode switch on PC, or in the middle position of the Model 12, for channels 1 and 2. You can set the other channels however you choose. The first thing to do is download the Model Mixer Setting Panel software from Tascam.com. This is found on the Downloads tab on the individual Model 12 product page. Go ahead and install the Model Mixer Setting Panel software. Now it's time to put Model 12 into DAW controller mode. Press the menu button. The multi-jog knob uses a turn and push method. Once you highlight a function, you can then push the knob to select it. Turn the multi-jog knob until you get to the DAW controller. Push the multi-jog knob to select DAW controller. Model 12 has presets for the most popular DAWs, so highlight Mackie Live. Press the multi-jog knob to select it. The Model 12 will ask you if you are sure and want to start the controller mode. Press the far right button directly under the display or yes. Model 12 displays a notice that only track channels 1 and 2 can be used as the default for Ableton Live. Press the multi-jog knob, enter. The Model 12 is now in controller mode and its faders and most of its knobs are disabled to the internal Model 12 functions. Tascam cannot provide customer support for your software program, computer, or computer configuration. Here are the settings on this computer, which is a MacBook Pro using Ableton Live Lite. The first thing we need to do is set the Model 12 up as a USB audio interface. So on the upper left, we click Live, choose Preferences, and we want the Audio tab here. There's an audio input device and an audio output device setting. For the audio input device, click and choose Model 12. For the audio output device, click, choose Model 12. The next thing we need to do is set up the control surface protocol between Model 12 and Lite. That's a MIDI function. So we click Link MIDI. Control surface is selectable here. I click that. There's a lot of options here. The Model 12 uses the Mackie control protocol. So I choose Mackie control, click that. As far as the MIDI input goes, choose Model 12, output, choose Model 12, that's done. So at this point, let's close the window. Okay, now that we have that set up, we can go to the Model 12. We can change the faders. You can see that respond on Ableton Live. Everything works. Master works. Pan pots are live. Transport control. Stop. Let me hit tab on my computer. Start it again. Fast forward. Rewind. Stop, and even the dial will scroll through live. So everything works. The default is to control tracks 1 through 8 on your DAW. This screen is the marker set screen. This is where you can set markers on your DAW by pressing the set button underneath the display while the file plays. To control tracks 9 through 16, press the menu button on the Model 12. The Model 12 will display track. Then press the arrow to the right button under the display, and DAW tracks 9 through 16 are controlled. To control tracks 17 through 24, press the display arrow to the right again underneath the display. Now tracks 17 through 24 are controlled. To go back to tracks 9 through 16, or 1 through 8, press the display button to the left over and over, and tracks 9 through 16, or 1 through 8, are then controlled.